This is Dr. Haugeberg giving some information on the third TMEA tenor trombone etude. This etude is from Jaime Voxman's Selected Studies for Trombone and is on page 25. This is by Oscar Baelma. Its key is B flat minor. The tempo marking is 88 to 98 beats per minute. And some stylistic markings you need to Google include allegretto and leggere. The phrase construction, it's a rondo form with 8 measure phrases, A, B, A, C, A, with a short extension on the final A. You'll need to know arpeggios and scales in the key of B flat minor, B flat major, C minor, C diminished, D flat major, E flat minor, E diminished, F major, G minor, and A flat major. Some common problems. Incorrect rhythms and unstable tempo. Shortchanging or lengthening the eighth notes. Clipping the eighth notes too much. Playing all staccatos too short and losing tone. Playing too fast for your ability. Poor tuning during the arpeggios, especially those in the last four measures. Ignoring dynamic changes, ignoring the slur patterns, and complacency when repeating slide motions and don't adjust for intonation across the partials. Some suggested alternate position use. In measure 5, play the second F in a sharp fourth position. Measure 22, play the B flat in fifth and the F in 6th position. Measures 25 through 27, play the B flats in 5th position, the upper Cs in 6th position, and the upper D flat in 5th position. For measure 31 and 32, play the D flat in 5th position and the F arpeggio in 6th position, with the E flat in 3rd position. In measure 38, play the F in a raised fourth position. In measure 40, play the second F in sixth position and the second B flat in fifth position. In measure 41, play the first B flat in fifth position and the first F in sixth position. And in measure 43, play the first B flat in fifth position, the second F in sixth position, the second B flat in trigger third, and the third F in sixth position. Some suggested practice strategies. Remember, slow practice makes fast progress. I suggest subdividing the eighth notes into 2/16th notes and doing so externally so you can hear 2/16th notes in that space. Chain continuous 16th note passages forwards, backwards, and targeted around a specific note. Use a drone to solidify pitch, especially when practicing alternate positions. Gliss passages to ensure steady air and full tone throughout. Isolate note fronts and slide alignment by bopping in a steady tempo. isolate small passages, but always put them back in context afterwards. And finally, remember, it's not about the quantity of practice. It's about the quality of practice. Thank you so much for watching our presentation today. If you have any questions, please feel free to email.